हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। फर्स्ट लेक्चर में हमने जो भी पॉलीमर है उसका बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन और क्लासिफिकेशन के बारे में पढ़ा था कि जो भी पॉलीमर है तो पॉलीमर की क्लासिफिकेशन है वो वन कैटेगरी में नहीं कर सकते, क्योंकि पॉलीमर हैज़ अ डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशन, दे हैव अ डिफरेंट केमिकल कॉम्प्लेक्सिक स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड केमिकल बिहेवियर्स। दैट्स वाई पॉलीमर इज अ क्लासिफाइड इन टू दी फाइव कैटेगरी। फर्स्ट कैटेगरी इज दी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द सोर्स। इन दिस कैटेगरी फर्स्ट पॉलीमर इज द नेचुरल पॉलीमर। दिस टाइप ऑफ पॉलीमर आर फाउंड इन द प्लांट एंड एनिमल। दिस टाइप ऑफ पॉलीमर आर फाउंड इन प्लांट एंड एनिमल, दैट्स वाई दिस टाइप ऑफ पॉलीमर इज नोन एज अ नेचुरल पॉलीमर। मीन्स जो ऐसे टाइप के पॉलीमर है जो हमें नेचुरली कोई भी चीज़ से मिलते हैं, यानी कि नेचर में क्या होते हैं, ये एक होते हैं प्लांट और दूसरे क्या होते हैं एनिमल, यानी कि प्लांट और एनिमल्स में से जो भी पॉलीमर्स फाउंड होते हैं उस पॉलीमर को हम क्या बोलते हैं, नेचुरल पॉलीमर। तो उसके एग्जांपल्स ऑफ द नेचुरल पॉलीमर आर प्रोटीन, सेल्यूलोस, स्टार्च, सम टाइप ऑफ रेजिन्स एंड रबर्स। प्रोटीन, एज वी टेक एग्जाम्पल प्रोटीन, तो प्रोटीन इज अ मेडअप ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एमिनो एसिड एंड दिस प्रोटीन इज ऑल्सो फाउंड इन द प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल, दैट्स वाई प्रोटीन इज द नेचुरल पॉलीमर। लाइकवाइज सेल्यूलोज, स्टार्च, सम रेजिन एंड रबर इज ऑल्सो फाउंड इन प्लांट और एनिमल, दैट्स वाई दिस टाइप ऑफ पॉलीमर इज नोन एज अ नेचुरल पॉलीमर। देन सेकेंड इज द सेमी सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर। सेमी सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर इज द पॉलीमर दैट आर मेड बाय अ केमिकली ट्रीटिंग अ नेचुरल पॉलीमर। मीन्स एज फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी टेक अ सेल्यूलोज, सेल्यूलोज इज द नेचुरल पॉलीमर, बट वेन दिस सेल्यूलोज इज केमिकली ट्रीटिंग, वेन हम जब जो भी सेल्यूलोज है उसको केमिकली ट्रीट करते हैं और उसमें से जो भी सेल्यूलोज एसिटेट और सेल्यूलोज नाइट्रेट बनता है तो उसको क्या बोलते हैं, सेमी सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर। मीन्स नेचुरल पॉलीमर इज अ ट्रीटिंग केमिकली एंड मेड सेमी सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर। द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द सेमी सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर इज सेल्यूलोज एसिटेट। अनदर नेम ऑफ द सेल्यूलोज एसिटेट इज द रेयोन, देन सेल्यूलोज नाइट्रेट एक्सेट्रा, दैट आर अ यूजुअल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस सब कैटेगरी। देन थर्ड इज द सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर। ऑल द मैन मेड पॉलीमर आर सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर। सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर, द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर इज द प्लास्टिक, मीन्स पॉलीथीन, सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स नायलॉन 6-6 एंड सिंथेटिक रबर मीन्स ब्यूनास, दैट आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द मैन मेड पॉलीमर। एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ पॉलीमर इज एक्सटेंसिवली यूज इन डेली लाइफ एज वेल एज इन द इंडस्ट्रीज। एज फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी टेक अ पॉलीथीन, पॉलीथीन इज ऑल्सो यूज इन अवर डेली लाइफ एज वेल एज इन द इंडस्ट्री। Then second type of classification of the polymer is the on the base of structure of the monomer chain. There are three different type based on the structure of polymer. First is the linear polymer. This type of polymer consists long and straight chain. Those type of polymer which contain only long and straight chain structures, these type of polymer is known as a linear polymer. Example of the linear polymer are high density polyethylene and polyvinyl chloride, means PVC. PVC is also used in a pipe, and high density polyethylene. In another lecture, we know about high density polyethylene and low density polythene. Here we know the example of the linear polymer. The linear example of the linear polymer are high density polyethylene and polyvinyl chloride. Then we see the structure of linear polymer. Linear polymer are represented as this type, means this type of polymer has a straight long chain type structure. Then another polymer is the branched chain polymer. These type of polymer contain linear chain and having some branches. And example of this type of polymer is the low density polyethylene. The branched chain polymer is represented as this type, means this type of polymer contain longest straight chain and also contains some branch. Then third classification is the cross-linked or network polymers. These type of polymers are usually formed from a bifunctional or trifunctional monomers, means these type of monomer contains bifunctional group or trifunctional group, and they are contain the strong covalent bond between the various linear polymer chain, means those type of structure is a very strong structure, means cross-linked polymer is a very strong in nature. The example of the cross-linked polymer are a bakelite and melamine. Then we see the structure of the cross-linked or network polymer is, then third is on the basis of synthesis. There are two type of the synthesis. First synthesis is the condensation polymerization. In this type of synthesis, monomer are a same or different unit. They are linked with each other by a covalent bond, and they eliminate small molecule like a water, methyl alcohol, etc. as a byproduct. Means two or more monomer is linked with each other and they eliminate a small molecule. This type of polymerization is also known as a condensation polymerization. This type of polymer formed is known as a condensation polymer. Nylon and terylene are a most common example. Condensation polymer is proceeded by the stepwise intermolecular condensation. That's why this type of polymerization is also known as a step polymerization, and polymer are found is also known as a step growth polymer. Here we see the example of the HMDA and adipic acid. This is a HMDA NH2CH26NH2 is a react with adipic acid COOH CH24COOH. What will happen here? Here one hydrogen and one hydrogen from here and one OH group from here is eliminate. That's why here H2O molecule, one water molecule is eliminate, and condensation polymer is formed. Means it is the HMDA hexamethylene diamine, and it is the adipic acid. When these two monomer are react with each other, One H2O molecule is the aluminate and this polymer nylon 6,6 is formed. That's why this type of polymer is known as a condensation polymer, or also second is known as a step growth polymer. Then second is a addition polymerization. In this type of polymerization reaction, two or more monomer is linked with each other, but they do not eliminate any small molecule and they form polymer, and this type of polymer is known as addition polymer, and this reaction is known as addition polymerization. These involve the monomer without loss of any small molecule. As for example, we take ethene. N mole of ethene molecule is linked with each other and they form a polyethene. Fourth classification is based on molecular forces. A large number of polymer application in the different field that are depend on their unique mechanical properties like a tensile strength, elasticity, toughness, etc. These type of mechanical property are governed by the intermolecular forces like a van der Waals bond, van der Waals forces and hydrogen bonds. The classification on the basis of the molecular forces are characterized on the four parts. First is the elastomer. Elastomer, in this type of polymers, polymer chain are held together by a weakest intermolecular forces. Means this type of polymer contain weakest intermolecular forces. That's why this type of polymer to be stretched. When weak binding forces permit the polymer to be stretched, because this type of polymer has a few crosslink are introduced in between the chain, which help the polymer to retract its original position after the force is released as in vulcanized rubber. Means elastomer is contain the weakest intermolecular forces. When we apply the forces on the in this type of polymer, this type of polymer to be stretched, when in this type of polymer some cross-linked is present in the two chain, this cross-linked is helped this polymer to retract. When we released the force on it, and this type of polymer is retract on its original position like a vulcanized rubber. Then the example of elastomers are Buna and neoprene, etc. Then second is the fibers. Fibers, in this type of polymer, polymer chain are held together by a strong intermolecular forces, and you also know the strong intermolecular forces is the hydrogen bonding. Means fiber contain the strong hydrogen bonding. This strong forces is also lead to the close packing of chain. Means this type of polymer contain the cross linking and thus impart the crystalline nature. Fibers are a thread forming solids and they possess the high tensile strengths and high modulus. You also know the fibers are in the thread form and the thread are very strong because the fiber is contain the strong intermolecular forces. Strong intermolecular forces like a hydrogen bonding, and this hydrogen bonding is a very strong bond, and This fiber is also contain the close packing of chain. The example of the fiber are a polyamide like a nylon 6-6. You also know the structure of nylon 6-6 and polyester. The another name of polyester is a terephthalene. Then third is a most important thermoplastic polymer. Thermoplastic polymer possesses the intermolecular force of attraction intermediate between the elastomers and fibers. Means these type of polymer contain the intermolecular forces is higher than the elastomers but lower than the fibers. These are the linear or slightly branched. You also know the elastomers contain the linear structures. Some linear structure and also contain branched. But fiber is contain the cross-linked structure and very strong structure. But this thermoplastic is contain the linear and slightly branched long chain structure that are capable of the repeatedly softening on heating and hardening on cooling. When you heat this thermoplastic polymer, it is the soft, it is become a soft, and when you cool this thermoplastic polymer, it become the hard. Some common thermoplastic, the name example of the thermoplastic are polyethylene, polystyrene, polyvinyl, etc. You know the reaction of the manufacture of the polyethylene, and in another lecture you also know the reaction of the manufacture of polystyrene or polyvinyl. And last category is the thermosetting polymer. This is the very strong polymer. This type of polymer is contain the cross-linked or heavily branched molecule. When you heating this type of polymer, which on heating undergo the extensive cross-linking in the mold and again become infusible. This type of polymer cannot be reused. The example of this type of polymer is a bakelite, urea formaldehyde resin, etc. And the last classification are based on a type of the monomer unit. First is the homopolymer. When polymer are formed by one kind of monomer, this type of polymer is called the homopolymer. Means if you take a N molecule of the ethene and you form a polyethylene, means in this type of polymerization reaction you take a one kind of monomer, then this type of polymerization reaction is a homopolymerization, and this type of polymer is called the homopolymer. When another is the copolymer or mixed polymer, when you take a one more than one kind of monomer unit, it is called as a copolymer. Means when you take a two or a three type of monomer in the polymerization reaction, this type of polymer is called as a copolymer.